The 25th space shuttle mission is now on the way. This morning, it looked as though they were not going to be able to get off.
73 seconds into its flight, millions watched in shock as the U.S. Space Shuttle Challenger exploded above Cape Canaveral in Florida on this day, January 28th, back in 1986. It killed all seven astronauts on board. Let's take another look.
Looks like a couple of the solid rocket boosters blew away from the side of the shuttle in an explosion.
Also on the space shuttle was the first ordinary civilian to take part in a space mission, 37-year-old Christina McAuliffe. She was selected from 11,000 applicants to be the first school teacher in space. It is unknown exactly at what point they would have died, but it's thought that they could have been conscious inside the cabin crew as it slammed into the Atlantic Ocean at 200 miles per hour. Not a cool day.
And liftoff of the 25th space shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
It was later determined that two rubber O-rings, which had been designed to separate the sections of the rocket booster, had failed due to the cold temperatures of the morning of the launch. The world was shook to its core, the newspapers read tragedy, people were frantic, and debris, well, it continued to wash up on the shore. A horrible reminder, it continued for a decade. They were still finding pieces. Prior to 9/11, this was probably the biggest disaster captured on live American television. Can you think of anything else? Sound off in the comments down below. My name is Michael McCrudden, and it's not only sad news we have for you on this day, January 28th. In fact, a lot of amazing things have happened. Some incredible birthdays. On this day, January 28th, back in 1985, Jermaine Cole was born. He's now known as J. Cole, but the rapper experimented with two other names. He was going to be Blaza or Therapist. Then he decided to settle on something a little closer to home. The guy really is a homebody. Named his album after his house and everything. We've talked about it in his Before They're Famous video. Let's take a look. Jermaine and his brother Zach, they are both biracial. Their mother Kay is white, and their biological father was African American. Also born on this day, Rick Ross in 1976. Now, he was previously known as William Leonard Roberts II, and before becoming a rapper, he was working as a correctional officer in Florida. Definitely, you know, that hits his street cred pretty hard, but we spoke about this in his After They're Famous video. He wasn't impressed. A website called The Smoking Gun released a picture of young Ross in uniform as a corrections officer. At first, Ross denied it was him in the picture, but after a whole lot of evidence of the past surfaced, Ross couldn't hide from the truth anymore.
And right now, to feed my family, I'll do it again.
There it is.
Yeah. To feed my kids, I'll go get it.
Thanks to our friends over at FamousBirthdays.com, we got a shit ton of people born on this day. Backstreet Boy Nick Carter in 1980, and NSYNC member Joey Fatone. I don't know what year he was in, but I'd say it was like 79. Elijah Wood, he was born in 1981. The eyebrows kid, known from such films as The Revenant, Will Poulter, he was born in 93. Rapper Rakim in 68, wrestler Sheamus in 78, and finally Ariel Winter in 1998. I'm wondering if you guys think I should make a Before They're Famous on her. I mean, she did reduce her breast size. Why would any woman do that? At least give me what you get rid of. Today in history, in 1547, arguably England's most famous king, King Henry VIII passed away at the age of 55, being succeeded by his 9-year-old son. King Henry VIII is a dude who created the Anglican Church because the Pope didn't approve of his 6 wives and counting.
Start my own church.
What?
Yes, my own church, where divorce will be so easy, more than half of marriages will end in it.
On this day, construction began on the Eiffel Tower in 1887. Completed 2 years after, it made its debut at the World Fair, and some French artists criticized it on the account of its strange design. But since then, it has become one of the most famous and recognizable buildings in the world.
Grabbing a souvenir from France. Oh, merci beaucoup.
I've also heard that there's an ultra-exclusive apartment at the very top. Can you imagine the view?
Wouldn't mind being up there with Ariel Winter. In a padded bra.
Finally, in 1958, the Lego company patented their design of Lego bricks, still compatible with the bricks produced today. If you want to know more about the Lego company, well, we made an entire video about them, so you should definitely check it out. The Lego company traces its roots back to Danish carpenter named Ole Kerr Christensen, who began making wooden toys in the early 1930s. Over the next few decades, he and his son Godfred would turn the humble toy workshop into the largest toy company in the world. Yeah, we make a lot of videos, because I love doing this. And on this day is the show concept that I truly believe in, and something I want to make a regular upload on this channel. But I need your feedback. Tell me what you think, what you like about it, what you don't like about it. and then we'll work away at making it better. Also, be sure to share this video with anyone who's celebrating their birthday today. I'll see you guys in another video.